My name is Sam Bagley. Cryptoassets, or more precisely, cryptocurrencies, represent a major revolution whose full implications are yet to be grasped. Cryptocurrencies challenge the paradigms underlying both the central bank's money monopoly and, even more broadly, public digital goods. Cryptoassets are digital goods, but as opposed to all other digital goods, they are scarce by design. They require mining, and the total number of units is always limited. Consequently, cryptoassets such as cryptocurrencies are rivalrous. There is no non-rivalry. These assets are rivalrous. In other words, there is a marginal cost associated with producing additional units. Cryptoassets are also excludable. In other words, access to and ownership of the cryptoassets is always restricted. Blockchain technologies, which underlie most cryptoassets, blockchain technologies are distributed, redundant, and autonomous, self-updating, propagated electronic ledgers. Because of the redundancy, because of the enormously wide distribution, because of the self-updating, because of the propagation, blockchain technologies present the first feasible solutions to counterfeiting, real-time transacting, scarcity management, monetizing intangibles, crowdsourcing, and a host of other hitherto intractable bottlenecks in business and finance. The risks attendant on cryptoassets are as big as the promises and the rewards. First of all, there is an issue of asset bubbles. Then there is money laundering, the financing of terrorism, cryptojacking, threatening the foundations of the financial value chain, and so on and so forth. These threats are amplified by the recent introduction of exchange-traded Bitcoin derivatives, options, and futures, by exchange-traded funds, and by mutual funds, which invest in crypto assets. Another threat is on the sovereign side. There are sovereign cryptocurrencies. Russia is contemplating one, so does Sweden, Venezuela, and other countries. If countries were to issue cryptocurrencies, this would grant putative future access and price-setting privileges and power to financial institutions, state institutions. This would commodify the underlying assets, in the best sense of the word. The main concern, though, is the fact that cryptocurrencies, though they do store value as investment vehicles, failed to become accepted means of exchange, especially in the retail industry and among governments. In the absence of this crucial function as a means of payment, as a means of exchange, without this function, cryptocurrencies are bound to wither and then vanish in a speculative boom and bust. One possible solution would be to link cryptoassets to crowdfunding as the main form of money in crowdfunding. Cryptocurrencies are actually crowdsourced, and the underlying blockchain technology would introduce rigorous fraud control beyond the current, rather flimsy, peer review cum peer pressure mechanisms. In P2P financing, the only guarantee against fraud right now is reputational. But blockchain technologies can make sure that no one cheats anyone else, and thereby amplify and massively enlarge the markets for P2P financing and crowdfunding, microlending, and other forms of alternative finance. This may be where blockchain technologies are most needed and will end.